Jonathan Pryce paid for his simple-mindedness, his lack of intelligence, his ignorance of understanding or wisdom with his life. He said, Jonathan Pryce, who adored white people, who loved white people, and yet the son of those Caucasian women that he's addicted to killed him. And it put me to mind, this is not new. Around in the 1800s, a man by the name of William Brown, they call him that because he shipped himself to freedom from Virginia to Maryland, which was, to Philadelphia, from Virginia to Philadelphia, which was a free state. We had a lot of abolitionists, and the Quakers was friends. They called friends, but they was friends of the enslaved people. And they helped in the Underground Railroad. Yet still, William Box Brown only spent a short time being an abolitionist giving speech against slavery. And then he went to England and he married an English woman. And after the Civil War, about 1875, he brought the English woman and his family back to the United States. So this was going on, this addicted to white woman. If you look at Pelosi, that's enough to scare you away from looking at any other white woman. Now here's what the Bible says, 7th chapter of Proverbs. With her much fierce speech, she caused him to yield. With the flattering of her lips, she forced him. He goes after her straightway, as an ox goes to the slaughter, or as a fool to the correction of the stocks, till a dart strikes through his liver, as a bird hastes to the snare, and knows not that it is for his life. Hearken unto me now, therefore, O ye judgment, and attend to the words of my mouth. Let not thine heart decline to her ways. Go not astray in her path, for she has cast down many wounded. Yea, many strong men have been slain by her. Her house is the way to hell, going down to the chambers of death. Yet foolish men still say they become addicted. How long would you be stupid of low intelligence? Now, this is the same verse in the Septuagint. So with much converse, she prevailed on him to go astray, and with the snares of her lips, forced him from. And he followed her, being gently led on, and as an ox is led to the slaughter, and as a dog to bonds, or as a hart shot in the liver with an arrow. And he hastened as a bird into a snare, not knowing that he is running for life. Now then, son, hearken to me and attend to the words of my mouth. Let not thine heart turn away to her ways, for she hath wounded and cast down many, and those whom she has slain are innumerable. The house is the way of hell, leading down to the chambers of death. And yet, there are many. And William Wells Brown, in his autobiography, said that the slave looked upon the white man, his master, as a god. The slaves look upon the slave master as a god. It must have been an evil god. And yet that same master sold his first wife, which was a slave woman, sold her away to another slave owner in Kentucky. And yet he considered that master kind.